Welcome to Jericho.
Listen, I got a shit hot tip for you. Number 5 in the third. Lickety split. That Philly's one hell of a chaser. You want a flutter?
Last shit hot tip you gave me sent me back a week's wages, baby.
Come on, this is different. It's 100% guaranteed. You can't go wrong.
I'm in.
Damn straight. Hey, you won't regret this.
What is your problem? Don't you ever do as you're told? Look, you don't have to follow me around like a poodle.
I'm sorry for my behavior back at the police station. I didn't mean to be unpleasant.
Oh, wow. You've even got a brown nose and apology program. Guys at CyberLife thought everything, huh? Here you go. Ah, thanks, Gary. I'm starving.
Don't leave that thing here.
Not a chance. Follows me everywhere. See?
This Pedro? He was proposing illegal gambling. Am I right?
Yeah.
And you made a bet?
Yeah.
Your meal contains 1.4 times the recommended daily intake of calories, and twice the cholesterol level. You shouldn't eat that.
Everybody's gotta die of something.
Is there anything you'd like to know about me?
Hell no. Well, yeah. Why do they make you look so goofy and give you that weird voice?
CyberLife androids are designed to work harmoniously with humans. Both my appearance and voice were specifically designed to facilitate my integration.
Well, they fucked up.
Maybe I should tell you what we know about deviants.
You read my mind. Proceed.
We believe that a mutation occurs in the software of some androids, which can lead to them emulating a human emotion.
In English, please.
They don't really feel emotions. They just get overwhelmed by irrational instructions, which can lead to unpredictable behavior.
Emotions always screw everything up. The androids aren't as different from us as we thought.
Can I ask you a personal question, Lieutenant? Why do you hate androids so much?
I have my reasons. You ever dealt with deviants before?
A few months back, a deviant was threatening to jump off the roof with a little girl. I managed to save her.
So I guess you've done all your homework, right? Know everything there is to know about me?
I know you graduated top of your class. You made a name for yourself in several cases and became the youngest lieutenant in Detroit. I also know you've received several disciplinary warnings in recent years, and you spend a lot of time in bars.
So what's your conclusion?
I think working with an officer with personal issues is an added challenge. But adapting to human unpredictability is one of my features. I just got a report of a suspected deviant. It's a few blocks away. You should go have a look. I'll let you finish your meal. I'll be in the car if you need me.
Hey, Connor. You run out of batteries or what?
I'm sorry. I was making a report to CyberLife.
Well, do you plan on staying in the elevator?
No. I'm coming.
Hey, what do we know about this guy?
Not much. Just that a neighbor reported that he heard strange noises coming from this floor. Nobody's supposed to be living here, but the neighbor said he saw a man hiding an LED under his cap.
Oh, Christ, if we have to investigate every time somebody hears a strange noise, we're gonna need more cops. Hey, were you really making a report back? Back there in the elevator? Just by closing your eyes?
Correct. Anybody home? Open up, Detroit Police!
Stay behind me.
Got it. Driver's license is fake.
Cool. At least we didn't come for nothing.
RT. Probably initials.
You put his initials in his jacket? That's something your mom does when you're in first grade. Some fresh air. Found something?
I don't know. It looks like a notebook, but it's indecipherable.
Jesus, I hate these things!
Its LED is in the sink.
Not surprised it was an android. No human could live with all these fucking pigeons. Any idea what it means?
RA9. Written 2,471 times. It's the same sign Ortiz's android wrote on the shower wall. Why are they obsessed with this sign?
Looks like mazes or something. I was the last guy in Detroit to keep some. Electronic books, you can't smell the paper. See the paper.
Ah!
Goddamn fucking pigeons! What are you waiting for? Chase it!
Thank you.
Shit! Oh, shit! We had it! Fuck!
It's my fault. I should have been faster.
You'd have caught it if it weren't for me. That's all right. We know what it looks like. We'll find it. Hey, Connor. Nothing.
Who are you?
Fugitives. Just like you. My name is Josh.
I'm Simon.
North.
This is Jericho?
It's a refuge for those who don't want to be slaves anymore.
And hiding just to stay alive, that's freedom to you?
Humans hate us. Hiding is the only way we can survive.
There is no safe place for those like us. If humans knew we were here, they'd kill us.
I don't understand. I thought Jericho was a place where androids lived in freedom.
We do live in freedom. It may not be what you hoped for, but here we have no master. We don't belong to anybody. I understand how you feel, but we have more freedom here than you ever did.
Humans were your masters, and now it's fear that rules you. You're no freer than you ever were. You've only found a new master.
You're lost, just like the rest of us. We didn't ask for this. All we can do now is deal with it.
You're safe here. You can stay with us as long as you want.
Go and see Lucy. She might be able to help you.
Shape, am I? My diagnostic program isn't working. I don't think it would have anything good to say anyway.
What happened to you?
They tied me to the back of a car. I think they wanted to have fun. I don't want to shut down. No, I don't want to shut down.
Humans are afraid of dying, too. Do you know what happens after death?
No. No, I don't.
Well, I'm about to find out. What's your name?
Marcus.
I was glad to meet you, Marcus.
What was your function before coming here?
What do you care?
A lot of these guys in pretty bad shape.
That's how the humans treat those who disobey. They despise us. They'll never accept what we are.
Who found this place?
Nobody knows anymore. Whoever he was, his body's probably laying somewhere on this boat. If you came here for comfort, you came to the wrong place.
Threw him out when they didn't want him anymore. He was living on the streets before we brought him here.
They'll all shut down if we don't find a way to help them.
To help them, we need blue blood and biocomponents. We salvage what we can from those who shut down. But there's never enough.
So, how do they survive?
They won't. We're slowly dying out.
Are you Lucy?
Sit down. Show me. I'll stop the bleeding. Drink this. Give me your hand. You had it all, and you lost it all. You've seen hell, and now hell lives in you. Your heart is troubled. A part of shadow and a part of light. Which will prevail? Your choices will shape our destiny.
Simon. I know where we can find spare parts. CyberLife warehouses in Detroit Harbor. They have everything we need.
The docks are guarded. We can't just walk in there and take what we want. Humans will never let us.
Which is why we won't ask permission.
We don't have any weapons. And even if we did, none of us knows how to fight.
We can steal what we need without fighting.
We'll just get ourselves killed.
Maybe. But it's better than waiting here to be shut down.
I'm with you.
Maybe it's worth a try.
Okay. I'm in.
Be okay? We'll get some help here. As soon as we'll all be just a bad memory. This is the place. Are you Zlatko?
Who's asking?
I was told you could help us.
I don't know who told you that. You came to the wrong place. I'm sorry.
Wait. We really need your help.
Come in. Come on in. Don't be shy. Luther, would you be so kind as to take these ladies' coats? Oh, don't be afraid of our big friend here. Luther is just another android that I helped. He keeps me company in this big, empty old house. Please, make yourselves at home. How did you hear about me?
An android. On the street, he said you could help us.
I see. Deviant, huh? What about her?
She's human.
And you want to find a safe place. Somewhere you can start a new life. I hear Canada is very lovely at this time of year. Beautiful landscapes, open spaces, clean air, and no android laws. Great place for a fresh start.
Yes, that's exactly what we want.
Of course. I can help you. But first, we have to get rid of your tracker.
Tracker?
Yeah. All androids are fitted with a tracking device to locate them at all times. I'll remove yours, and then you'll both be safe. Come on. Follow me. The little one can wait for us in the living room.
No, she always stays with me.
Of course. Right this way. Everything we need is in the basement.
I don't like this place. And that man. Let's go. I have a bad feeling.
Please excuse the mess. I needed somewhere discreet for my machines. Removing trackers is illegal, so I opted for discretion over comfort. I hope the little one isn't too scared.
No. No, she'll be all right.
That's good. This way, please. If you could just stand over there. I should warn you, this could be quite unpleasant.
Oh,
you know what's strange? For some unknown reason, the trackers seem to stop working in Deviance. That's why it's so hard to find them. So, actually, there's no reason to remove your tracker.
What? But you said that...
Yeah, people believe what they want. You Deviants are so naive. They'll come to me expecting me to help them. And I just reset them, sell them on. Or I keep them for my little experiments.
No! No! I don't want to be reset! Let me go!
Ah! Oh, I forgot about the child. Lock it up. I'll deal with it later.
Alice! Alice, no!
Wow. A deviant that wants to be a mother. That's so sweet. And so deluded. I think it's time we put you out of your misery. What you get for having a dream. It always ends up the same way. Tears and disillusionment. Believe me, you're better off being erased and feeling nothing. No more pain. No more hopes dashed. I almost envy you.
Kara!
Oh, poor little Alice. Oh, looks like Mommy doesn't remember you at all, huh? Looks like Mommy's completely forgotten you.
Carl, what happened to you?
Oh, all right, that's enough. Come on. You bit me. I'm gonna teach you some manners, you little bitch.
Meet me in the living room. Helix to play with us. Creating monsters for his amusement. But who's the real monster? Look what he did to us.
Yes, Locko.
Should be done here in 10 minutes or so. Have a look at the little one, see what I can do with it.
Understood, Locko. I'll bring you the little one in 10 minutes.
Has the Master authorized you to be here? You must always obey the Master. Oh yes, you must always obey. You should not be here. You have no business here.
You were right, we never should have come here.
We have to go. Follow me and don't make any noise, okay?
Luther!
Yes, Zarko.
I'm finished here. Go fetch the little one.
Right away, Zarko. Zarko!
What?
The little one is gone!
Well, I can't have just disappeared. We've gotta be here somewhere. What are you waiting for? Go look. Shit. Where are they?
Luther!
Find them, for fuck's sake!